Moja majka je uvjerena. Ubio je moj otac posle 16 godina neprestanog zlostavljanja nje, meni i mog brata. Godine 2014. kada je ubijena moja majka, naša lokalna služba iznio podatak da su te godine, za prvih 10 mjeseci, ubijene 43 žene, da je oko 80 djece u raznim životnim dobima ostalo bez roditelja. Ubijstvu su prethodile krivične prijave za porodično zlostavljanje, ali sudstvo i tužilaštvo nije reagovalo na to kako treba. A tu je da odredi automatski pritvor i sudsku presudu za zlostavljanje koja, koliko mi je poznato, predviđa kaznu zatvora 3 godine. Da je takva kazna donešena, moja majka bi danas bila živa.
Bosne i Hercegovine, misiji Bosne i Hercegovine i Vijeću Europe, Vijeće Europe i Agenciji za ravnopravnost spolova, koja je i najveći organizator i najglavniji pokretač ove aktivnosti. Ponosimo se činjenicom da je u predsjedavanju Bosne i Hercegovine komiteta ministara Vijeća Europe implementacija Istanbulske konvencije prepoznata kao jedan od glavnih prioriteta. Mi smo danas ovdje kako bi razgovarali o monitoringu ove konvencije, čijom će se implementacijom, nadam se, stvoriti uslovi od strane država potpisnica za sigurniji način života žena širom Europe. Neka ova konferencija bude poziv na akciju, neka taj poziv odjekne svuda, tako da možemo stvoriti svijet u kojem se svaka žena tretira s poštovanjem i dostojanstvom. Želimo da svaki dječak i djevojčica budu zbrinuti jednako, a svaka porodica ima nadu za jaku i stabilnu budućnost. To je posao koji je pred nama, to je djelo svih nas koji imamo viziju svijeta za našu djecu i za našu bolju budućnost. Želim istaći da Bosna i Hercegovina čvrsto vjeruje da je jedno od ključnih pitanja današnjice osnaživanje žena u svakom pogledu. Stoga vas uvjeravam da će moja država pružiti snažnu potporu provedbi Istanbulske konvencije. Bosna i Hercegovina će nastaviti s naporima koji su usmjereni na postizanje ciljeva ravnopravnosti spolova kao preduslova za punu demokratiju i kao najefikasnijeg oblika prevencije nasilja nad ženama i nasilja u porodici. Hvala vam za vašu pažnju.
Uobičajeno je na konferencijama za ovom tematikom da imamo više žena nego muškaraca. Naravno, različitih izuzetcima i nacionalnih izuzetanja. Jedan od izuzetaka upravo je tu danas sa nama, a to je naš predsjedavajući komisije za ravnopravnost spolova Parlamentarne skupštine Bosne i Hercegovine, gospodin ministar Šustaković, i ja ga molim da nas pozove.
Hvala lijepo, nisam se osjećao uopšte neprijatno, čak što više. Kaže sinoć na jednom događaju, njegova ekscelencija, ambasada Grčke, sinoć pita koliko ima žena, ja pomislim, koliko ima žena, koliko će, tri ima, a on je mislio na parlament, koliko ima žena u parlamentu. Dakle, hrvatski predstavnici komiteta ministra, parlamentarne skupštine Vijeća Europe, članovi komiteta za ravnopravnost i nediskriminaciju, parlamentarne mreže žena bez nasilja, predstavnici generalnih izvestioca parlamentarne skupštine o nasilju nad ženama, predstavnici vladinih institucija i članovi nacionalnog parlamenta, predstavnici GREVI, komiteta, strana, potpisnica ugovora, članovi međunarodnih parlamentarnih organizacija i nevladinih organizacija i ostali u ime Komisije za ostvarivanje ravnopravnosti spolova parlamentarne skupštine Bosne i Hercegovine želim vas srdačno dobrodošli u Bosnu i Hercegovinu i u njen najviši zakonodavni dom. Izbor teme ove konferencije u vrijeme predstavljanja Bosne i Hercegovine komitetom ministara Vijeća Europe pokazuje našu opredijeljenost da beskompromisnu borbu protiv društvenog zla koji predstavlja nasilje nad ženama i nasilje u porodici, kao i značaj koji Bosne i Hercegovine pridaje provođenju Istanbulske. O tome svjedoči naš odnos sve ovo vrijeme, od izrade konvencije pa do njenog prakticiranja. Sveliki zadovoljstvo želim naglasiti važnu ulogu koju je predstavnica naše agencije za ravnopravnost spolova imala u izradi konvencije. Zajedničke aktivnosti na promociji konvencije koje su slijedile nakon njenog usvajanja, a sve do ratifikacije parlamentu Skupštine Bosne i Hercegovine u nove 2013. godine, čime smo postali šesta zemlja članica Vijeća Europe koja je ratificirala ovu konvenciju. Dozvolite mi da napomenem i značajnu ulogu koju je u tim aktivnostima imala članica ove komisije, gospođa Istanbul, kao članica Komiteta za ravnopravnost i nediskriminaciju, parlamentarne mreže žena bez nasilja parlamentarne skupštine Vijeća Evrope. I na kraju, Bosna i Hercegovina usvojila i okvirnu strategiju za provođenje Istanbulske konvencije za period 2013-2018. Tako da smo uz objavljivanje prevedenog priručnika za parlamentarce o Istanbulskoj konvenciji na bosansko, hrvatsko, srpsko jeziku stvorili neophodne preduslove za potpunu primjenu konvencije.
Koja je, također moram reći, učestvovala veoma aktivno u izradi Istanbulske konvencije. I upravo će nam gospođa Šimonović da pokaže sinergije između međunarodnog dokumenta.
Dobar dan, dame i gospodo, drago mi je biti danas s vama zajedno. Your Excellencies, members of Parliament, and guests of all of this, may be represented with ladies and gentlemen, dear colleagues and friends. Let me begin by thanking the government of Bosnia and Herzegovina in the context of its chairpersonship of the Committee of Ministers of the Council of Europe for inviting me to participate in this important conference on new synergies and the implementation of the Istanbul Convention, and to address this topic from the annual time mandate as the United Nations Special Rapporteur on Violence Against Women, its effects and consequences. My appointment as Special Rapporteur in June this year by the United Nations Human Rights Council is both a great honor and a great responsibility. In my new capacity as Special Rapporteur, but also as a former co-chair of the CAFIO committee that was mentioned by Madame Filipovic-Hajjavic, the drafted the Council of Europe Convention on Preventing and Combating Violence Against Women and Domestic Violence, I'm very glad to see that the Istanbul Convention is fully operational and that its monitoring committee, the group of experts on action against violence against women and domestic violence, radio, has just started its work. I'm also glad that we have vice chairs of radio and other members of radio here, and hope that we will have exchange of information and views with respect to that work. I would also like to mention a very constructive role played by representative of Bosnia and Herzegovina during the elaboration of this convention, Ms. Samara Filipovic-Hajjavic, the head of gender equality agency, that contributed to final draft of this convention when we had very difficult negotiations during the period of 2 years. I would like to use this opportunity to congratulate all Council of Europe member states that have up to now ratified this convention for their political will and commitments to turn the standards of this convention into reality as a national.
Organised by the Bosnian Chairmanship, the Council of Europe, and the Council of Europe. The city of Istanbul is not only beautiful, but it's also very symbolic. Why is it symbolic? Because 4 years ago, exactly 4 years ago, the very first promotional event of the Istanbul Convention took place here. And that was only very few months after the convention was opened for signature in May 2011. Many of the people that were in this event 4 years ago promoting the Istanbul Convention are here today. And of course, I want to pay tribute to Ms. Sinovic, who was also at that event, but at that time, as a co-chair of the Pavia committee, which was preparing, drafting the Istanbul Convention. And of course, we already have mentioned the role played then by Ms. Deroch, and of course, Zahira. So this is a symbolic now that the very first implementation event of the Istanbul Convention also takes place here in Bosnia. And I think it's a sign of the commitment of the Bosnian authorities in really making sure that the Istanbul Convention will be what it is expected to be. So the Istanbul Convention has often been described as a promise or a safety net to women victims of violence or risk. But experience shows that such promise can only be turned into reality through a strong and effective monitoring and actually effective implementation of the convention. The drafters of the Istanbul Convention clearly bore this in mind. The entry into force of the convention last year, August last year, triggered the setting up of a powerful two-tiered monitoring mechanism. On one side, a group of experts on action against violence against women and domestic violence, radio, that we have here the first vice chair, Ms. Naudi, and the members are sitting. And the second tier is the committee of parties, which not only elects the members of radio, but also follows up on its findings. And we have the honor to have here the first chair, Ambassador Lenker, sitting in the front row. So much of the credit of the fact that we have now launched the monitoring of the convention is due to the Committee of Ministers of the Council of Europe, which started or adopted the rules of election of members of radio in November 2014. And this enabled the parties to select highly qualified candidates and the committee of the parties to elect the very first 10 members of radio. And that happened last May. And the newly elected members of radio had their very first meeting just about 1 month ago in Strasbourg. And we can proudly say that today the Istanbul Convention's monitoring mechanism has successfully been put into operation. Today's conference sends an important signal. Radio and the Committee of the Parties will not, nor do they want to be, left alone in this challenging task. Synergies with all key stakeholders are in. And I think today's conference is a signal that we are really all together trying to reach these objectives. So who are the key stakeholders? Let's start with the government's coordinating bodies, established under Article 10 of the Convention. They are the driving force of the national machinery on preventing and combating violence against women and domestic violence. As such, these coordinating bodies have four fundamental tasks: coordinating, implementing, monitoring, and evaluating the government's action.